back. I've been ill and really busy, so hasn't been a lot of streaming. But I'm going to try to do some today just so I can move things along. We're running a little bit close to the end of the month now, to only be on chapter 10 of a chapter of a many chapter game. And as you can see from this, I've been busy. I've wrapped up all the side quests and stuff from chapter 10. Which wasn't that interesting. And literally I couldn't find anything else to do except for, I think, there was a new side quest, which previously had not been seen. Where did I do it? Ah, there are two new side quests. So I need to go to Pater's Manor via Banktown. Cranktown is up here. This will probably just be running around fetching stuff, but it is hashtag content, so I'll include it in the stream. But apparently there's some really interesting stuff in chapter 11, and hopefully we'll get to that. Did I mention I've completed all the levels that I can? I've completed all the levels that I can. Because the hexagons are the bit of the game that I enjoy. And now they are forever exhausted. Except for there's one bit on, I forget where it is. On the top tier, that's right. That I can't get to yet. Hey Devon. Yeah, Freezer Town is terrible. It's just like four dungeons needlessly stacked back to back.
Hi.
Do I have a beast's beard mushroom?
Hi.
Oh, good grief. I was not expecting that. I'll go and do the other thing and see where it gets us. Being able to teleport back to base from any tier is a godsend. Not least because I keep forgetting which end of these core lifts I'm at. Versus which end I'm supposed to be at.
Hi.
Oh, good grief. Two quests that require me to do actual stuff. So which levels do I need to go to? Pitotopolis is one, which is over there.
Beats sitting around at home all day.
See, now I'm just imagining these particular dwellers doing the safety dance. I'm kind of okay with that.
Get a load of this.
That was a waste.
You want some of this?
Ha! I'm not dying today! One-way ticket down!
I hope it's
too late
useful.
For regrets! Always having to lighten my enemy's pockets.
What chapter are you on, Devin?
Anybody left?
Do this just like all the rest, and everything will be fine.
I am not okay with there randomly being level 73 enemies here. Even if I know I can take them.
Time for my business.
Oh no.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
You gotta be kidding.
Those interrupts are the worst.
Thought. sit back and... You want some of this?
You're gonna swim in your own blood!
Things are about to get messy.
Too late for
That didn't work.
Come on, don't jam on me now!
No time for-
I'm gonna blow you
up! Oh god. Try this again. It's not enough bezels.
I like it when it gets messy.
We'll never have enough bezels. But spend some time hex grinding and go down to level 12, and there's like almost two bezels worth of shards. This game's poison status, by the way, yet, Devin.
You fight with the wrong girl. Better than you deserve.
So as far as I can tell, what the poison does is it causes scratch damage at the time, but also if you leave scratch damage untreated for a turn, it converts that to permanent damage. And it is the most brutal thing. There's a fight further down with three of these guys. Yeah, like I said, it's pretty horrible. I think I went pink last time I was here, so let's go blue.
Do this just like all the rest, and everything will be fine.
Two of those guys, and I have a feeling those are the ones that vomit poison on you. Sigh. Yep, here we go.
You're in trouble now.
Too late. You want some of this? Too late for regret.
Of course, now I'm stuck with Leanne on reduced health for the rest of the dungeon. Unless I want to waste a perfect aid on a side quest.
Poor unlucky bastards.
Thank you. Oh, crap.
You're gonna wish you were dead. Not really my kind of weapon.
On the other hand, I did just induce one of those guys to kill his buddy, so saves a little effort.
Gotta be kidding!
Look at it this way. At least you'll die together.
The shot got through. That's all I needed. Don't ask why the bosses in this game. I know JRPG enemy design is weird, but this game is really weird.
Always having the light in my enemy's pockets.
So the serious point to ask about boss design is about the number of bosses that are clearly animal mechanical hybrids. Because there are a lot of them.
Too late. It's like a fall.
And it suggests a level of symbiosis between the creature and the world. Given the extent to which this game holds the idea of the mechanical tower and the world itself to be synonymous. Frozen status is pretty much the pits, but all the statuses in this game are bad. Like, they're all... It's another case of that thing of not doing quite the Final Fantasy thing, but here it's just that they've added an extra layer to every status to make it that much more vicious. Like, the poison thing is poison plus disease. Which is harsh. Frozen is a sleep that isn't broken by attacks. And is reapplyable. Where was the other place I needed to go? Oh, that was Freud Remnant. Also, I should sleep. Yep, if all three characters get frozen, it is indeed game over. Target the little gremlin dudes first, because they're the most common source of freeze, and they're also really easy to kill.
They'll be dead before they have a chance to regret it.
Well, these guys should be okay. Provided I don't forget to switch Vash out of heal mode.
It's all about having the right tool for the job. Too late! You've gotta be kidding! Thank you.
I was on the wrong character. Yeah, there's a stage this game goes through in about that chapter and a couple either side of it, where it's very much like the key is manipulating the AI like you would in a TRPG. It starts feeling a lot like Valkyria Chronicles.
To lick my wounds.
Don't blink.
Trying. Show me what you've got. My bullets are a one-way ticket down.
Hey Leroy, yes, I'm doing side quests. I'm doing this side quest and then hopefully plot stuff. And hopefully this side quest is just this, this encounter.
Too late for regret! You want some of this? Looks like a f- That means.
Screen is choppy? I'm not seeing any dropped frames or any bitrate issues.
Who do you think?
Although I do know the actual connection box out in the street.
You forget to reload.
My connection at the moment is knackered. Like the covers come off it. Did I get the quest item I need? Beast's Beard Mushroom. I'm guessing not. Hey, look, I found video games. Probably gonna have to clear all four of these, aren't I? Oh, there we go.
Here we go! Pretty boy, looking to clear the well.
I
from this!
Is the music not on? I'll turn it on when we get out of this encounter. I probably had it off, so I saw something else while I was grinding. I have the volume. I generally have the volume down really low when I'm streaming as well, so I don't notice. I don't know if it's actually better at triangles. I'm certain enough that it's button mashing. Because I am scum.
Coming back from this!
Well, that's gonna make this interesting.
This is it!
That's the first time.
I like it when they keep me guessing.
Yeah, I feel like hero actions are much more important. Which is a bummer given how few bezels they give you to start off with, because it teaches you completely the wrong lesson. I've been super conservative with my bullets so far. Also, I was going to turn the music back up a bit. It does help if I actually pick the confirmation option from that menu. So something that's interesting to me that's picking up on something Leroy said a little while ago about backtracking. All the fast travel options that the game eventually does give you, and they're hard earned, but all of them are only for returning. It's only escape hexes and the teleport back to base. You never get a teleport out, as far as I'm aware.
Hi.
Oh, good grief. Wait, was the reward for that a shirt? Oh yeah, it's just the icon just looked a bit like a skirt for a moment. Also, so far, I think skirts have been the most precious item in the game. Make of that what you will. Really, game?
Enemies this dumb don't know what they're in for. Lucky bastards.
Yeah, I bought a few bits of clothing when the bee outfits happened, but most of the clothing I have in my wardrobe is from exploring the world map.
His mad skills.
Oh, that's not good. Zephyr taking the SMG with him. That's not the street I wanted to end up on. There's a weird thing with, because how the world map works, it's actually quicker for the guild and the base to leave to the world map than it is to walk through town. Because the town has a lot of dead space that's just for showcasing how the place looks. Because it's the first real sight you get of it.
What's that?
I'll walk through town because it's beautiful, but I want to get on to chapter 11. Okay, I don't need to save, I'm about to start a new chapter. Also, is it just me or does saving take ages in this game? Like FF12 levels of time.